Good morning, Miss Rossetti, Mr. Fallon. Good morning, Ms. Rossetti, Mr. Falico, parents joining us via live stream, staff and fellow students. Welcome to our Malloy Cup Sports Awards and Leadership Assembly. As a part of today's proceedings, we will reveal our most successful house for the 2021-2022 year, as well as the highest achieving students in each year group. We will celebrate the exceptional talent and commitment that many of our students have demonstrated in sport throughout the year. We've had many successes this year, and this awards giving event congratulates our sportsmen for their commitment, dedication, and success. In the final part of today's assembly, the succeeding college leaders from Year 11 for 2023 will be announced. Leader of Academic Life, Sean Cullen, will lead us in singing our national anthem, and Leader of Religious Life, Joshua Blaine, will lead us in prayer. I now invite College Vice Captain Jason Wu to the lectern to lead us in the acknowledgement of country.
As Indigenous and non-Indigenous people together, let us have a sense of the importance of the country upon which we are standing, where learning and ceremony has taken place over many thousands of years. Let us sense the land beneath our feet and acknowledge to whom it belongs, the Wallumattagal people, and pay our respects to their elders and all elders, past, present, and emerging. For we too are one in land, one in spirit, one in faith, united in God's love.
Please stand for the national anthem.
Australians, all let us rejoice, for we are one and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauties rich and rare. In history's page, let every stage advanced Australia fare. In joyful strains, and let us sing, advanced Australia fair.
Leader of Religious Life, Joshua, will now lead us in prayer.
As we celebrate our gifts, talents, achievements, and recognize the commitment that we all share in our Marist community, let us take a moment to pause, reflect, and offer thanks to our Lord for giving us all the opportunities to be the best versions of ourselves. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Dear Lord, we thank you for our talents and gifts. Help us to strive to use them wisely for the benefit of our Marist community. Guide us to fulfill your plan for each of us. Give us the grace to be humble, respectful, and tolerant this day and all the days of our lives. Thank you for the thoughtfulness and purpose you have poured into us. We pray that we would recognize what those talents are and what they're used for. We pray we would be good stewards of using our gifts and talents for your will. Help us to encourage one another and support one another to use our gifts and talents for your glory. Amen. Mary, our good mother. St. Marcelin Champagnol. St. Mary the Cross. And let us always remember the Father and the Son, Holy Spirit.
To kick off proceedings today, we will begin presenting sports awards from earlier in the year for rugby league, soccer, athletics and chess. Please welcome House Leaders Eric Alieco, Louis Demento, Joshua Jason Newen, Marcus Battery, who will present these awards today.
To Term 2 saw the college compete in football and rugby league in the new Sydney Catholic School sports competition. With the new competition came some new school rivalries, particularly in rugby league, where pools were not always decided by their geographical location. Competitions were graded based on schools' performances, which saw some great success and very competitive rugby league matches this year. Congratulations to our under-15s rugby league and A-grade rugby league teams on making the semi-finals in their respective competitions. I would like to now acknowledge and invite Ms. Rossetti to present the team awards for rugby league. Please hold your applause until the end. Under-13s rugby league, best forward, Luke Grant. Best back, Samuel Myhill. Under-15s Rugby League. Best forward, Dino Giuseppini. Best back, Rocco Bragg. A-grade Rugby League. Best forward, Bradley Kelly. Best back, Jackson Lansdowne. Please join me in congratulating the Rugby League Award recipients.
Our football season saw Eastwood offer a record 11 representative teams this year, more than the school has ever been able to offer. After a very competitive season, we had some outstanding results from a number of teams. Congratulations to our Intermediate D football team, who won their grand final and were winners of the B-grade intermediate competition. We had all three Eastwood's top A teams qualify for finals football. Our Junior A team played incredibly well all season to go down in their semi-final in a close game. Our Intermediate A and Senior A football teams both had outstanding season qualifying and competing in the grand finals, which both ended up going to overtime. Despite challenges and results not going our way, the team showed great resilience and attitude to finish runners-up and will now look to go one better next season. I would like to invite Mr. Falico to present these teams with their grand final medals and the team awards for our college football teams. Intermediate A football team, Michael Ajaka, Damian Arrow, Edwin Savazian, PJ Dominello, Jonathan Governos, Sion Jevondian, Anton Imbro, James Lopez, Jake Medanik, Ryan Nefranovic, Nicholas Papakiriku, Will Stanger. Congratulations, gentlemen. The Senior A football team, Luca Ulwood, Matthew Chan, Zet Chong, Max Gavrin, Alex Henry, Harry Keyes, Christopher Marchi, Philip Mazar, Jason Nguyen, Jeremy Plummer, Ricky Sheether, Dominic Smith, Jack Stanger, Samuel Valderrama, Oliver Varga, Daniel Yazbek, and Luke Nefranovic, the coach. Congratulations to a great season by these two teams. Now, this season's team awards, please hold your applause till the end. Junior A, best player, Charlie Tome. Coach's award, Harry Byron. Junior B, best player, William Della Vedova. Coach's award, Emin Giovandian. Junior C, best player, Nicholas McNally. Coach's award, Jabril Thame. Junior D, best player, Daryl Ardy. Coach's award, Ashton Sawtell. Intermediate A, best player, Jonathan Governos, Coach's Award, Nicholas Papakiriku. Intermediate B, Best Player, Ethan De Silva, Coach's Award, Kostas Vasilidis. Intermediate C, best player, Vikin Vartikian, Coach of the Award, Zane Demoulin. Intermediate D, best player, Will Hodges, Coach of the Award, Kylan Altamulian. Senior A, best player, Harry Keyes, Coach of the Award, Jason Ewan. Senior B, best player, Oscar Waterson, Coach of the Award, Oliver Sheikhi. Senior C, best player, Raiko Watson, Coach of the Award, Jack Attani. Please join me in congratulating the Football Award recipient.
Last term, the college hosted our athletics carnival at Sydney Olympic Park. The day was a great success, demonstrating Eastwood's incredibly talented athletes. We would like to acknowledge the age champions and runners-up for each group. Under 12s, runners-up, Robert Tanous, age champion, Toby Gill. Under 13s, Will Scully, age champions, Giorgio Hazzarati. Under 14s, runners-up in his absence, Ashton Sawtell and age champion, Zachariah Aboud. Under 15s runners-up, William Stanger, age champion, Andrew Kalos. Under 16s runners-up, Lucas Sasson, age champion, Luke Lay. Under 17s tied runners-up, Philip Mazza and Julian Ajaka, and age champion, Davide Rosetto. For our opens, runners-up Bernie Lyons and age champions, Jack Stanger. Please join me in congratulating the athletics champions. In one of our most exciting editions of the Eastwood Gifts, the handicap race, which sees Eastwood's fastest competitors in each age group and the fastest runners in the school contest a handicap 100 metre race. For the first time ever, we had a dead heat for first position. The students ran the exact same time, down to a thousandth of a second. I will now invite both Marist College Eastwood Gift winners for 2022, Edward Savazian and Nicholas McHaling, to the stage to accept their trophies from Miss Rossetti. This term, we have seen our athletes have the opportunity to represent the school at two carnivals, the conference level and the Sydney Championships. We would like to now highlight some of our medal winners and standout performers from the Sydney Championships. Congratulations to our Marist College Eastwood medal winners. Please hold your applause until the end. Robert Tanous, bronze in the shot put. Tom Egan, bronze in the triple jump. Zach Aboud, bronze in the high jump and silver in the relay. Oliver Smith, bronze in the 1500. Luke Lay, bronze in the triple jump and conference age champion. Nicholas McNally, silver in the 800 metre. Nikhil Kumar, silver in the relay. Oliver Huang, silver in the relay. Zach O'Donoghue, silver in the relay. Isaiah Morris, silver in the relay. William Stanger, silver in the relay. Jacob Hazrouni, silver in the relay. Julian Smith, silver in the 1500. Giorgio Hazzarati, two silvers in the 1500 metre and relay. Levi Palfrey, two silvers in the shot put and relay, and was the conference age champion. Andrew Kalos, two silvers in the triple jump and relay, and one college athletics record. Lachlan Waldron, gold in the discus. Jordan Cortell, silver in the discus and gold in the shot put, and three college athletics records. Our athletics squad captain, Jack Baker, silver in the 800 metre and gold in the 400 metre. And Davide Rosetto, bronze in the 200 metre, silver in the triple jump, and gold in the long jump, was the conference age champion and was also crowned the Sydney age champion for the 17 plus age group, also having one college athletic record. Nathan Barbara, gold in shot put and discus, and two college athletic records. And finally, Michael Jarka, two silvers in the 100 metre and relay, and two golds in the shot put and discus, as well as four college athletics records. We would now ask Levi Palfrey, Michael Ajaka, Davide Rosetto, and Jack Baker to present to Miss Rossetti and the school the major trophies, Eastwood was crowned the junior, intermediate and senior conference champions, as well as the overall conference and overall Sydney champion school for athletics. Congratulations to all of our athletics.
On the last day of term, Eastwood hosted the Conference Chess Gala Day. The school sent an impressive 18 teams across three divisions. I would now like to invite Brandon He and Joshua Beltran to present the junior and intermediate chess trophies to Ms. Rossetti on behalf of the chess team. We had a number of outstanding results, which you can see on the screens. In the juniors, Eastwood finished first, second, and equal third. In the intermediates, first and second. In the seniors, second and equal third. I would now like to invite the students involved in the Chess Gala Day to stand in their seats. Collectively, Marist College Eastwood was crowned the Chess Conference Chess Champions. Can we please give the chess team a round of applause?
Good morning, Ms. Rossetti, Mr. Falico, teachers and students. Today we will be celebrating the achievements of Marist College Eastwood students in the sporting arena. We'll be presenting our Eastwood medals to our highly accomplished students, our Player of the Year awards, and we'll finish with Marist College Eastwood's highest sporting honour, the Sportsman of the Year awards. The major awards for this year are awarded to athletes based on their performance and involvement in sports from Term 3 last year, 2021, through to the end of last term. The Eastwood Medal is awarded to students who have not only represented the school, but have represented the diocese in a Sydney Catholic Schools team competing at a New South Wales CCC level, to students who have contested at a New South Wales CCC carnival, and to students who have competed at the New South Wales All Schools and the Australian All Schools levels. I would like to invite Ms. Rossetti and Mr. Falico to present the Eastwood Medals to the following students. Oliver Huang, Triple C Swimming. Aidan Yang, Triple C Swimming. Marco Cardinal, Triple C Swimming. Henry Dipinar, Sydney Catholic Schools Golf. Giorgio Hazzarati, Triple C Cross Country. William Scully, Triple C Cross Country. Julian Smith, Triple C Cross Country. Caleb Yao, Triple C Swimming. Zach Abood, Triple C Cross Country. Harry Jordan, as part of the Sydney Catholic Schools Touch Team competing at the New South Wales CCC Trials. James Lopez, CCC Cross Country. Matthew Costello, CCC Swimming and New South Wales All Schools Swimming. Jai Satula was part of the Sydney Catholic Schools Rugby League squad that competed at the New South Wales CCC Trials. Oliver Smith, Triple C Cross Country. Ben Tao, Triple C Swimming and New South Wales All Schools Swimming. Oliver Wilson, Triple C Swimming and New South Wales All Schools Swimming. Lucas Yao, Triple C Swimming, New South Wales All Schools Swimming. Baden Haggerty, New South Wales All Schools Baseball. Philip Mazza, was a member of the Open Sydney Catholic Schools football team that competed at the New South Wales Triple C trials. Xavier Mousley, Triple C cross country. Lucas Sasson was a member of the Sydney Catholic Schools touch team competing at the New South Wales Triple C trials. Oliver Sheikhi, New South Wales Triple C cross country and New South Wales All Schools cricket. Ryan Hinteregger, Triple C cross country. Harry Keyes was also a member of the Open Sydney Catholic Schools football team competing at the Triple C trials. Sean Marston, Triple C swimming and New South Wales All Schools swimming. Ricky Sheether was a member of the Open Sydney Catholic Schools football team, which was competing at the Triple C trials. Dominic Smith, Triple C cross country. And Jack Stanger, Triple C cross country. Could we please join in a final round of applause for our Eastwood Medal recipients? We'll now invite Ms. Rossetti to present our major to the college, our Player of the Year awards. These awards are given to the students who have shown the greatest level of achievement of each sport, of all the sports contested at the college. Firstly, our Swimmer of the Year. The recipient of the Swimmer of the Year for 2022 is an outstanding swimmer whose name is now littered throughout our school records books. This year he was crowned the MCE, the Sydney Catholic Schools Conference, and the Sydney overall age champion. He's a New South Wales Triple C event winner and further represented the college at the New South Wales All Schools Swimming Carnival, where he was where he competed individually in four events, winning a bronze medal in the 200 metre individual medley. This athlete is genuinely proud of his school and always represents Marist College Eastwood to the best of his ability. Congratulations to this year's Swimmer of the Year, Sean Marston. Our Cricketer of the Year. Whilst there was no cricket played in the 2021-2022 season with COVID restrictions and a change in sporting pathways, this particular athlete had an outstanding summer for his club team Parramatta in Saturday grade cricket. He also represented the college proudly at the New South Wales Triple C cricket trials. His performance at these trials ensured he was selected in the New South Wales in the New South Wales All Schools tournament. Congratulations to this year's Cricketer of the Year, Oliver Sheikhi. A Rugby League Player of the Year. This player was a key leader and consistent contributor to the team. Whilst his preferred position is in Eastwood's back line, this player was able to cover multiple positions each Thursday, depending on what the team needed. And for this reason, he is the side's heart and soul. His game is characterised by explosive involvement with the team, with the ball in hand, but also a defensive steal when they didn't. This player always led from the front, being the first player to put his hand up when the going got tough, and he never gave up on the contest. His workload and fitness throughout the game saw him involved in almost everything, and his class as a footballer is unquestionable. Congratulations to Marist College Eastwood Rugby League Player of the Year, Bradley Kelly. Athlete of the Year. During 2021, most traditional school athletic pathways were interrupted due to COVID. Despite this, we had two athletes who both excelled in athletics. Our first athlete of the year has continued to raise the bar, competing in a range of state and national competitions. Last year, this athlete was a dual New South Wales All Schools gold medalist in the shot put and the discus. In February, this athlete competed at the New South Wales Junior Championships and placed fourth in the 100 metres, won a silver medal in the shot put and a gold in the discus, setting a new national record. At the New South Wales State Little Athletics Carnival, Jim, we might stop and pray the angels together. Thank you, gentlemen and staff. I might just repeat this so that we do give this athlete a chance. Last year, this athlete was a dual New South Wales All Schools gold medalist in the shot put and discus. In February, this athlete competed at the New South Wales Junior Championships, placing fourth in the 100 metres, won a silver medal in the shot put and a gold in the discus, setting a new national age group record. At the New South Wales Little Athletics Carnival, this athlete won a silver in the shot put and gold in the discus again. In April, this athlete progressed to the national championships, competing in the Australian Track and Field Championships. What made these results stand out was that this athlete was also competing up a number of age groups and won a silver medal in the shot put and a bronze medal in the discus, again, setting another Australian record in the shot put. Congratulations to our first athlete of the year, Nathan Barbara. Our second athlete of the year was able to show his incredible talent and was crowned the 2021 Marist College Eastwood Under 14 Age Champion, whilst also breaking two school records last year. Outside of the school pathways, this athlete has medalled at New South Wales All Schools, winning a gold medal in the discus and a silver in the shot put. The athlete qualified for the Australian Track and Field Championships in two events, the discus and the shot put, placing fourth in the shot put. The student not only excelled in throwing events, but has specialised in multi-events, achieving some fantastic results across a range of events, including sprints, jumps, throws, and middle distance. The athlete won the Under-15s New South Wales Little Athletics Multi-Championships, the New South Wales Heptathlon Championships, and qualified and placed inside the top 10 at the National Heptathlon Championships. Congratulations, Marist College Eastwood Athlete of the Year, Michael Ajaka. And I'm going to ask Michael to stay on stage just for another second. Yesterday, Michael competed at the New South Wales Triple C State Carnival, where he won the shot put, he won the discus, and placed second in the javelin. He was therefore crowned the New South Wales under 15 state age champion. Congratulations. Our cross country runner of the year. Eastwood's cross country runner of the year has once again demonstrated incredible devotion to his training and pursuit of athletic greatness. This athlete won his age group at the college cross country carnival, but was also the fastest runner in the whole school. At the first edition of the Sydney Catholic Schools Sydney Championships Carnival, this athlete placed second overall in his age group. This was the best placing by any Marist College Eastwood student. He was also the fastest under 16 athlete in our conference, and he qualified for the New South Wales Triple C Carnival. Unfortunately, due to illness, he was unable to compete at the state carnival, which now marks the second time he's missed an opportunity to compete at the New South Wales All Schools Cross Country Carnival, despite qualifying last year. Congratulations to our Eastwood Cross Country Runner of the Year and the school's fastest endurance athlete, Oliver Smith. Our Footballer of the Year. Marist College Eastwood's Footballer of the Year goes to a player that stood up in big moments of big games, scoring some crucial goals throughout this season. His strength on the ball and the ability to read the play and beat a man created headaches for the opposition defence. He is a player that puts in for his team and is always ready to fight for victory. He has managed a large football workload outside of school, and his leadership and effort to drive his player during games have improved and were central to our success of our team this year. He was rewarded for his outstanding performance being selected for the Sydney Catholic Schools representative team. Congratulations to Harry Keyes, who is this year's Footballer of the Year. Basketballer of the Year. Marist College Eastwood's Basketball of the Year is an immense presence on the court and has embodied the culture that staff and students have worked hard to achieve over the last few years. On the court, he was a leader who led through action, pushing himself, his teammates, and younger members of the squad to be better. On court, he demonstrated finesse with great footwork and a silky jump shot. However, conversely, he adopted our beloved junkyard dog mentality with enthusiasm, being a presence in the paint, blocking shots, grabbing rebounds, and had a great hook in the low post. He led in a number of statistical categories this season, particularly in points, rebounds, and blocks, and was an incredible presence in the intermediate team, leading the squad to the grand final. Congratulations to Gabriel Markov, and thank you for your service to the basketball program at Marist College Eastwood. Our Touch Football Player of the Year. This year's recipient of the Touch Football Player of the Year is awarded to a student who led our senior touch football team. The student was a key figure in the team with great vision and knowledge, his speed and versatility in open play. The player's exceptional skill and ability in touch football were demonstrated in his selection to the Sydney Catholic Schools representative open touch football team, where he was to travel to Nelson Bay to contest the New South Wales Triple C Touch Football Carnival. Congratulations to Lucas Sasson on his high level of representation and being Touch Footballer of the Year for 2022. our Water Polo Player of the Year. If you travelled down to Auburn or Des Moines Swimming Pool in Term 1, you would have noticed two things. The first, every Eastwood player trying out of their skins, learning a new game and getting better with each game. The second, there was one athlete down there that was a class above the rest. This player is a daunting figure who struck fear into the opposition, often end up being double teamed at the goal face, and often this didn't matter. This athlete was the Open's leading goal scorer, and if he wanted to, could have represented at higher levels in this sport. Congratulations to this year's Water Polo Player of the Year, Hayden Andrews. Baseball Player of the Year. Our 2022 Baseballer of the Year is awarded to a senior student who for a number of years has excelled at the sport. For the second year in a row, this student has qualified for the Open New South Wales Triple C state team while still only being in year 11, competing against older athletes. Just recently, this player was also selected to represent Australia in the Ausball Australia Australian Waves under 18 team and will be travelling to the United States of America to participate in the Perfect Games International in Palm Beach, Florida. This will put him up against some of the best American high school and college talent. Congratulations to our 2022 Baseball Player of the Year, Baden Haggerty. Now for our major awards. We would like to present to the college our Sportsman of the Year awards. These awards are presented to Eastwood's best all-round athletes. Points are awarded and accumulated for school sport representation and additional points for further honours and accolades in these sports. Firstly, our nominations for our Junior Sportsman of the Year. Aidan Yang, Marco Cardinal, Giorgio Hazzarati, Julian Smith, Will Scully, and Levi Palfrey. The 2022 Junior Sportsman of the Year represented the college in Sydney Catholic School competitions in water polo and football. He represented Marist College Eastwood at the Sydney Conference Championships in both swimming and athletics, and he qualified for the Sydney Championships in swimming, cross country, and athletics. He represented Sydney Catholic Schools at the New South Wales Triple C State Swimming and was a school swimming age champion as well as a Sydney Catholic Schools runner-up age champion. Congratulations to this year's Junior Sportsman of the Year, Marco Cardinal. Give a final round of applause for Marco. Our nominations for Intermediate Sportsman of the Year. We have Michael Ajaka, Rocco Bragg, William Pizzuti, Matthew Costello, Oliver Smith, and Luke Lay. In a hotly contested age bracket, the Intermediate Sportsman of the Year nominations all scored between 19 and 22 points. This year's winner represented the college in basketball and football on a Thursday. He's our school's age group champion for athletics. He further represented the college at conference, Sydney Championships, New South Wales Triple C, New South Wales All Schools Athletics Carnivals. At the New South Wales All Schools Carnival, competing against all students statewide, he won the discus and placed second in the shot put. He has already been recognised as Marist College Eastwood's Athlete of the Year. The 2022 Intermediate Sportsman of the Year is Michael Ajaka. To our final sports award. This is our most prestigious sports award, and it's great pleasure that we recognise all of the students who have worked over many years as senior students to represent their school in a variety of sports. Our nominations for Sportsman of the Year are Sean Marston, Jeremy Plummer, Oliver Sheikhi, Ricky Sheetha, and Philip Mazza. The Sportsman of the Year is Eastwood's highest sporting accolade, and this year is awarded to one of Eastwood's finest all-round athletes. This student represented the college in touch football, where he received a team award, and football, helping his side to a conference grand final. He is a college senior runner-up age champion for athletics, and also represented the college at the Sydney Championship level in both cross-country and athletics. Finally, this student went on to further honours in his primary sport, being selected in the Sydney Catholic Schools representative football side. Congratulations to the 2022 Sportsman of the Year, Philip Mazza.
Thank you, Mr. Mulhern, and congratulations to the many sportsmen whose contributions were recognised here today, and to all the boys who trialled and participated in Sydney Catholic School sport over the past year. Finally, to all of our staff who give up their own time to coach all of our sporting and co-curricular teams, we may not always show that we appreciate the early mornings, late afternoons, long bus rides and patience at games. However, we very much appreciate it, so thank you. Would you please now join me in welcoming Year 11 student Jesse Malik, who will perform his rendition of Chicken Tendies by Clinton Kane. Thank you.
Hello? I saw someone who looked like you in the backseat with her head down the sun. I swear it was the dress that I gave you. I wonder if a favor comes through. Our love and power free, chasing every dream of possibility. You're more than I could ever be. we treat you better than our
Thanks very much for sharing your talents with us today, Jesse. It's never easy getting up on stage and performing, but we appreciate it. Thanks very much. I now welcome Leader of Events, Alec de Pergola, and Leader of Culture, Cameron Last, to MC a Malloy Cup proceedings. The House Leaders, Jason Newen, Erica Alieco, Louis Demento, and Marcus Badawi, will congratulate the winners from their house alongside College Vice Captains, Jason Wu, and Oscar Stewart, with Ms. Rossetti to present certificates.
Thank you, Jack. It's now time for us to reveal the Malloy Cup results. As it has been in previous years, the winning house is determined by your involvement, behaviour, and academic progress. Malloy Cup points are allocated to the houses of boys who have represented the school in sport, debating, chess, and other extracurricular activities. Your good behaviour is recognised through bronze, silver, gold, and principals awards. Points are allocated to students who additionally achieve assessment task placements and diligence and effort awards for honourable efforts in their subjects. Moreover, involvement in school events such as Open Day, the Duke of Edinburgh, and other community functions attracts points for yourself, which is ultimately aggregated to your house. The next few slides will display the points each house collected in each year group, before we will highlight the students who have contributed the most points for their house in each year group. The winning students from each year group are to come onto the stage to receive their certificate of recognition. Please stand next to your respective house leader once you have received your award. So we'll start with the Year 7 slides. So Year 7, Maloney House, Elliot, Cusack,
Maloney 502 points, Elliot 522, Cusack 613, and Leopold 604. There you go. You can now.
All right, the Year 7 nominees.
Congrats, Cusack.
So from Elliot, we have Andre Kedolian, Leopold Alexi Nazer, and Leopold once more, Aidan Yang. And we can declare the winner as Aidan Yang.
Now to Year 8. Maloney, 319 points. Elliot, 409. Cusack, 551. And Leopold, 478. Congratulations, Leopold. So good they showed it twice. The nominees for Year 8 are from Maloney, Charlie Tome, from Leopold, Campbell Girk, and from Cusack, James McCann. And the winner is James McCann from Cusack.
Nine. Oh, apologies.
Oh, he's here. James McCann.
All right, I do apologize for that. I think we jumped the gun on the results, though. They are there. So we have Maloney on 320 points, Elliot on 346 points, Cusack on 317, and Leopold taking it out on 416. And we'll get it right this time, the Year 9 nominees. So from Maloney, we have Jacob Hasrooney, Cusack, Anthony Macken, and Leopold, Rocco Bragg. And the winner is Rocco Bragg.
Now to Year 10. Maloney, 350 points. Elliot, 565. Cusack, 452, and Leopold, 537. Congratulations, Elliot. Now for our nominees. From Leopold, Luke Lay. From Maloney, Oliver Smith. And for Elliot, Toby Piccolo. And folks, this one's going to scare you. It's a tie. Oliver Smith and Toby Piccolo.
Thank you. 11 now. So Maloney. So yes, Maloney on 448, Elliot on 349, Cusack on 527, and Leopold on 253. Okay, the Year 11 nominees. From Elliot, Oscar Waterson, Leopold, Jesse Marlick, and Elliot once more, Philip Muzza. And the winner is Philip Muzza.
Now for Year 12. Maloney, 601 points. Elliot, 581. Cusack, 412. And Leopold, 582. Congratulations to the best house, Maloney. Now for our nominees. From Maloney, Jack Stanger. From Elliot, Sean Cullen. And from Maloney, Oliver Varga. And the winner is Oliver Varga. Now we move on to our sports carnivals. All right, so first up, swimming and athletics. Maloney, 180 points. Elliot, 80 points. Cusack, 140 points. And Leopold, 160 points. Congratulations to Maloney again. Now for our merits, Malloy Cup and cross-country points. Maloney, 2,600. Elliot, 2,852. Cusack, 2,813. And Leopold, 2,970. Now it's time to reward the final results. The winner of this year's Malloy Cup. I believe we have a nomination. In fourth place, on 2,780 points, Cusack. In third, with 2,932 points, Leopold. In first place, with 3,130 points, continuing their six-year reign, Maloney! Congratulations to Maloney and House Captain Marcus Baddowey for winning the 2022 Malloy Cup. That closes the 2021 and 22 House year. Congratulations to all individual nominees and winners today. Again, congratulations to Maloney and the House Leader, Marcus Battowy, for winning the 2022 Malloy Cup. Good luck to the... Good luck to the boys in Year 7 to 11 next year in the Malloy Cup. Continue demonstrating discipline in all that you do. Continue trying your best in class. Continue working hard at home. Continue participating in school events. Continue trialling for sport and debating teams. Continue participating in carnivals. Continue participating in the wide range of co-curricular opportunities the college has to offer. You only get what you put in, so don't expect more until you do. Thank you.
Thank you, Cameron and Alec, and congratulations to Maloney. We now move on to the announcement of the College Senior Leaders for 2023. Firstly, I invite the incumbent senior leaders on stage. Leader of Events, Alec de Pergola. Leader of Culture, Cameron Last. Leader of SRC, Peer Support and Wellbeing, Marcus Delavadova. Leader of Mission, Social Justice and Stewardship, Matthew Arkins. Leader of Academic Life, Chad Ridgway and Sean Cullen. Leaders of Religious Life, Friedrich Gagliano and Joshua Blaine. House Leaders, Jason Newen, Eric Alieco, Louis Demento, and Marcus Battowy, and Vice Captains Jason Wu and Oscar Stewart. The 2022 Leadership Group, alongside Mr. Rossetti and Mr. Falico, will congratulate the new leaders who will be announced today. I now welcome Year 11 Leader of Wellbeing, Ms. Berlin, to announce the students from her year group that will lead the college in 2023.
It is with great pleasure that I stand before you here today to announce the senior leaders of 2023. This group of leaders has been elected by their peers with a tough act to follow from the 2022 leaders. This is a positive challenge that I am sure that they will take on. And congratulate Jack and the leadership team and their entire group for the way they have led the college this year. Not just in words, but in action. Boys, when your name is called, can you please stand next to your incumbent leader? Leaders of Event is Raymond Zhang. Leader of Culture, Noah Mahaya. Leader of SRC Peer Support and Wellbeing, Luke Nefranovich. Leader of Mission, Social Justice and Stewardship, Lachlan Stevenson. Leaders of Religious Life, Lucas Boyle and Philip Mazza. House Leaders, Ken Armstrong for Leopold. Davide Rossetto for Cusack. Oscar Waterson for Elliot. And Jaden Kong for Maloney. And to our major leadership group, the college vice captains, Matthew Nassif and Nicholas Pelham. Oh. It's not there. Sorry, I missed one, so I'll have to. That leaders of academic life are Stanley Sapunas and Nicholas McCallion. And it's with great pleasure that I announce Alexander Lim as our college vice captain for 2023. Please join me in congratulating these young men and wish them luck in the challenge of leadership in the coming year. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Berland, and good luck to the 2023 Leadership Group. On behalf of the 2022 cohort, we wish you all the best for your leadership of the college next year. It is with great pleasure that I now welcome College Principal Ms. Rossetti to the lectern for her principal's address.
Good morning to our parents joining us via live stream, to staff and to all of the students here this morning. It really has been a wonderful assembly and lots of excitement, a little bit like the Academy Awards with the Malloy Cup. And it's been an affirmation of not only the talents and achievements of our students, but also an acknowledgement of their efforts and perseverance in the sporting, co-curricular and academic life of the college. We're also able to thank our outgoing Year 12 college leaders who have been exceptional leaders and who will be greatly missed. But we also congratulate our newly elected leaders who've made the conscious decision to step up into leadership. Leadership is a decision. It's a choice that you make, knowing that the path is not always easy, nor is it always fair. Leadership requires that you take accountability for your actions. It's great to be able to take the credit for any successes, but being a leader also means that you take responsibility for things that go wrong. It means that you hold yourself accountable. It's been said that being a good leader is like being an elite warrior. Not in terms of how tough or smart or fast you are, but rather how willing you are to help the person on the left of you and to the right of you. You need to be really good at helping people. Leadership means being there for others, being accessible, and helping others, as well as knowing when to ask for help and to accept it when it's being offered. Being a leader requires that you continually strive for your personal best. A leader does not need to hold an official position or badge. Many of the young men that we acknowledge this morning have all demonstrated leadership qualities. They've all set out to achieve their personal best, to strive for excellence, setting themselves new challenges to help them grow and develop, with and without a badge. We're all capable of striving to be the best we can. And in doing this, when we are striving to be the best athlete or the best house, we find ourselves competing with one another. The word competition sometimes evokes a negative connotation, but it doesn't need to be. We can compete cooperatively, just as the young men that we saw up on stage did today. As humans, we are by nature social beings, and so to be in cooperation is natural. Competition is something we learn and often needs to be entered into. So how do we learn to compete in ways that align with our basic values, preserving our own integrity? I want to leave you with three suggestions today that apply whether you're talking about competition in sport, in assessments, in the classroom, or anything in which you're competing. Number one, never denigrate your competitor. You'll never look good by trying to make someone else look bad. Number two, never do anything to undermine your competitors. We must be allowed to be to present ourselves and to be judged on our own merits. We want to not treat competitors as inferior or try and be humiliating. The thing we say, when we say we're in this thing together, it implies that we are perfectly capable of competing with each other in mutually respectful ways. Number three, always place the common good above self-interest. That doesn't mean that we ignore our own interests or we never serve them, but it means what it says, that we should place the common good above self-interest in our hierarchy of goals. Be always asking, does the action serve the common good? Is my pleasure causing others pain? Are my desires socially desirable? Is my main purpose self-satisfaction or self-advancement, or is it help to advance the cause of social harmony, freedom, and equality? Life is a cooperative project, and that applies where we are talking, whether we are talking about our personal or professional lives. So I hope today you can all learn to cooperate with each other respectfully while still engaging in healthy, respectful competition, as we saw all of the award winners demonstrate today. So congratulations to all the young men who were recognised today, and to all the young men sitting in the audience who maybe were not called up but continue to strive for their personal best on a daily basis, even if they haven't been officially recognised yet. Congratulations to you all. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Rossetti. Could I please invite the succeeding 2023 leaders and the 2022 leaders to the stage to lead the college in a subtum. Boys are reminded to participate as a community with respect and integrity. Please be upstanding.
Good afternoon, gentlemen. Boys, I just want to start by congratulating everyone involved in today's assembly, from our award recipients to Mr. Mooney's crew in the background, and most importantly, to all those present. Your behaviour, your